Good evening, everybody. Today I'd like to give an alternative synopsis of the Thai Buddhist Evening Prayer, or the Wat Yen. Tham Wat Yen. And give some translations. So to chant it stanza for stanza in order for Westerners or English speakers to remove the mysteriousness of kata, which people think of as some kind of spell, where actually kata means speech. And so most kata are Dhamma teachings from the Buddha or from other realized beings, and are statements which lead to knowledge and enlightenment and liberation, if understood. And that's where the magic happens, in the transformation and liberation that comes through the enlightenment of understanding, which comes through having heard and understood the Dhamma. But people like to mystify it into something very occult. But actually kata does not mean spell, magic spell. It means speech or explanation or a synopsis or declaration, speech. Kata. And so this, if we demystify it and we realize that when we don't understand the Pali and we chant it, it sounds very exotic. But if we speak the meaning as a speech to be understood under statement of truth, or certain statements about, in this case, about the Buddha, the Dhamma and the Sangha, reverence and recognition of the accomplishments, is basically a logical and meaningful text, a meaningful speech, meaningful declaration, and it is not anything mysterious. And so I would like to present the evening prayer in this way. Not as something exotic and mysterious, but rather to reveal it and lift the veils on it to what is actually being said. So here we go. If it was evening prayer in just Thai, then would be shorter. And this will be longer because I have to chant once again in English. Well, speak. Oh, here we go. Yo soho pakawa arahang samma sampoto. To him, the Blessed One, the Accomplished One, the Supremely Self-Enlightened One, having extinguished all the flames of desires and becoming rightly enlightened through his own efforts. Sawakato yena pakawata tamo. To the teachings of the Blessed One, which are well taught and expounded and explained. Subhatipanno yassa pakkhavato savakasangho. And to the disciples of the Blessed One, who are well practiced. Tammayang pakkhavantang sattammang sasangkhang. We worship the Blessed One, his teachings and his disciples. Imehi sakarehi yatarahang aropitehi apipuchayama. With these proper offerings to render supreme homage. Satuno pante pakawa sujiraparini putopi. I will repeat. Sato no pante pakawa sujira parini putopi. It is beneficial for us that the Blessed One, having passed away for long, but leaving the great benefits behind. Pachimara natano kampamanasa. The Blessed One has great compassion to us who are the later generation. Ime sakare tukata panakara pute patikanhato. May the Blessed One accept these offerings of ours. Amhakang tikaratang hitaya sukaya. For our long-lasting welfare and our long-lasting happiness. Arahang samma sampurto apakawa. The Buddha is the accomplished one, the supremely self-enlightened one, the blessed one, who has extinguished all the flames of desires and has become rightly enlightened through his own efforts. Purtang pakawantang apiwa teme. I pay homage to the Buddha, the awakened and blossomed one who is well knowledgeable. Sawakato pakawata tammo. The teachings of the Buddha are well expounded and explained. Tammang namatami. I salute those teachings of the Buddha with joined palms. Supatipannoa pakkhavato savaka sangho. The disciples of the Buddha have practiced well. Sankham namami. I bow down with respect to them. And then a monk would lead, which is not chanted by the congregation. Hantamayang putatsa pakawato bopapaka namakarangaromasehe. Now let us pay preliminary homage to the Buddha, is the meaning. Namo tatsa pakawato arahato samma sambuddhatsa. Homage to him, the blessed one, the accomplished one, the supremely self-enlightened one. Namo tatsa pakawato arahato samma sambuddhatsa. Homage to him, the blessed one, the accomplished one, the supremely self-enlightened one. Namo tatsa pakkhavato arahato samma sambuddhatsa. Homage to him, the blessed one, the accomplished one, the supremely self-enlightened one. Hantamayang puttanutsatinayang garomasehe. Now let us chant the recollection of the Buddha. Tangko panapakawantang ewang galayano kitisato apukato itipiso pakawa arahang sama sampoto. Thus far and wide has the reputation of the Blessed One spread, because of reasons such as these, that the Blessed One is having attained Nibbana, the supremely self-enlightened one. Vichajarana sampanno sukato lokavitu anuttaro purisa tamasarati satta teva manotsanang puto pakavati. The perfect embodiment of wisdom and virtue, the auspicious path finder, the knower of all realms, the incomparable tamer of individuals, the supreme master of devas and men. That means actually the teacher of both angelic beings and humans. The awakened one who is knowledgeable, self-awakened and blossoming by virtue of the Dhamma, and also who possesses the ability to teach the Dhamma selectively according to each person's understanding. Puttawara hantawarata tikuna piyuto. The Buddha is endowed with fine virtues such as the sublime virtues of an arahant. Sutta piyana garunahi samakatato. In him could be found profound insight and pure compassion. Potesiyo sukhanatang kamma langwa suro. He makes the righteous men awakened, just as the sun makes the lotus blossom. Wantamahang tamaranang sirasa chinintang. I join my palms in the gesture of respect and bow to him who has no defilements remaining. Puatoyo sapapani nang saranang kemamotamang. Any Buddha at all is one who is the highest and secure refuge for all living beings. Patamanut satita nang wantamitang sirenahang. I bow down low to the Buddha, to that Buddha, the exalted one, who forms the basis for my first factor of recollection. Putat sahat saming taso watasi putto jatsami kitsaro. Sorry, I will repeat. Putat sahat saming taso watas. And if you're a girl, you say tasi. So if you're a boy, puttatsa hatsamitaso puto me samigitsaro. And if you are a girl, you say puttatsa hatsaminta si puto me samigitsaro. And it means, I am indeed the servant of the Buddha. The Buddha is my great master. Puto tukatsakata jawitata jahitatsame. The Buddha is my suffering destroyer, the destroyer of my suffering, and is the bestower of benefits to me as well.
Putatsahang niyate me sariranchi witanjitang.
Sorry, I repeat.
Puttatsahang niyate misariran chivitan jitang.
To the Buddha, I sacrifice my body and my life.
Wantantohang.
If you're a woman, you will say wantantihang. So, I say as a man.
Wantantohang jaritsa mi puttatse wa supotitang.
I, whoever the Exalted One, will walk his excellent path of awakening.
Nati me saranang anyang puato me saranang warang.
I have no other refuge than the Buddha, who is my supreme refuge.
Etena sajena watayang sato sasane.
By the declaration of this truth, may I be prosperous in the teachings of the great master.
Puatang me wantamanena.
Or if you're a girl, wantamaneya. So I say as a man.
Puatang me wantamanena yang bunyang basutang ita.
I, whoever the exalted one, and with the merits I have obtained, may all dangers be overcome through their power.
Yang bun yang basut as.
Sorry, start again.
Sapepe antaraya me mahesung tatsate chasaha.
May all dangers be overcome through their power. And bow down to the floor.
Gayena wa jaya wa jetasawa,
whether by body, speech or mind,
pute kukamang pagatang mayayang,
whichever evil karma I may have committed to the Buddha,
puto patikanhato ajayantang,
may the Buddha forgive me for all those faults,
kalantare sangwaritong wa pute,
for the sake of later restraint towards the Buddha, for the sake of leaving your faults of the past behind and continue our practice without worries to drag around with you about what you did wrong. So to leave it behind in that moment. Now let us chant the recollection of the Dhamma.
the second factor of refuge. So Wakato Pakawata Tammo, the Dhamma is well expounded by the Exalted One. Santitiko, it is something which one who learns and truly practices will realize by his self. Akaliko, it is something which can be actually practiced and yields results without the limitation of time. This means that if you contemplated it 5,000 years ago, it would be found to be true. If you contemplated the same Dhamma now or 5,000 years in the future or 10 million years, it would still be found to be true because it is a Dhamma. It is the Dhamma. It is true and unbreakable. Agaliko means timeless. Ehibatsiko, it is also something worthy of telling others to take heed of and listen to and get to know. Opanayiko, it is also something which ought to be respectfully observed and adopted and practiced if understood. Pajatang vititapo vinyuhiti, as it is also something that can only be realized through personal experience. And then the tamapikiti hantamayang tamapikitingaromasehe. Now let us chant the supreme praise of the Dhamma. Sawaka tatati kunayo kawasena sayo. The teachings of the Buddha are something sublime because they consist of all the virtues so well expounded by him. Yo makapaka pariyatta vimokha petho. It is divided into the path, the fruit, the pariyatti or scriptures, and nibbana. Tammo guloka patana tata tari tari. It keeps those who uphold it from falling into the world of evil. Vantamahang tamaharang varatamma metang. I rever that superb Dhamma which removes all darkness of mind. Tamoyo sapapaning nang saranang kemamutamang. The Dhamma is the highest and secure refuge for all living beings. Tutiyanod satitanang vantamitang sirenahang. I bow low to the Dhamma which forms the basis for my second factor of recollection. Tamatsa hatsaming taso wat. Or if a girl tasi wat. So, as a boy. Tamatsa hatsaming taso wat. Tamome sami gitsaro. I am indeed the servant of the Dhamma. The Dhamma is my great master. Tammo tukatsakata jawitata jahitatsame. The Dhamma is my suffering destroyer and my benefit bestower as well. Tammatsahang niyate misariran chiwitanjitang. I'll say that once more clearly. Tamatsahang niyate misariran chiwitanjitang. To the Dhamma I sacrifice my body and my life. Wantantohang, or if a girl, wantantihang, so as a boy. Wantantohang jaritsami. I who rever the Dhamma will walk the Dhamma's excellent way. Tamatsewa sutamatang. Nati me saranang anyang, tammo me saranang warang. I have no other refuge. The Dhamma is my superb refuge. Etena sajja vachena vatayang satu sasane. By the declaration of this truth, may I be prosperous in the teachings of the great master. Tammang me vantamanena, or if a girl, vantamanaya, so as a boy. Tammang me vantamanena yang bunyang basutang ita. I who rever the teachings of the Buddha and with the merits I have obtained, sapepe antaraya me mahesung tatsate chasaha. May all dangers be overcome through their power. Kayena vajaya Wa jeta sa wa tamme ko kamang pakatang mayayang is done bowed with the face down to the floor and means, whether by body, speech or mind, whichever evil karma I may have committed towards the Dhamma or offences towards the Dhamma, tammo badikan hato ajayantang, may the Dhamma forgive me for the whole fault. Kalantare sangwaritung wat tamme, for the sake of later restraint towards that Dhamma in further practice, without worrying about previous transgressions. Then the last and third factor with the thinking of and praise of the Sangha. Hantamayang Sankhano Tsatinayangaromase. Now let us chant the recollection of the Sangha. Supatipano Pakawato Sawakasanko. Of good conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One, the Savaka, the monks, the ordained ones, the bhikkhus of the Lord Buddha. Ochupatipanoa pakawatoa sawakasangko. Of upright conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One. Yaya patipanoa pakawatoa sawakasangko. Of right conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One, who practice in order to know well the Dhamma, which frees us from suffering. Sami jibatibanoa pakawatoa sawakasangko. Of proper conduct is this community of noble disciples of the Exalted One. Yatitang jatari burisa yukani. The noble disciples of the Exalted One are such people, namely the four pairs of men. Atta burisa bukala, the eight individuals. Esa pakawato sawakasangko, this community of noble disciples of the Exalted One, is ahunayo, worthy of gifts, bahunayo, worthy of hospitality, takinayo, worthy of offerings, anchaligaraniyo, worthy of reverential salutation, anotarang bunyake tanglo katsati, worthy of the incomparable field of merit for the world. And the praise of the Sangha comes with sankapikiti. Hantamayang sankapikiting garoma sehe. Now let us chant the supreme praise of the Sangha. Satamacho sopati kunatiyoto. Sorry, start again. Satamacho sopatikuna tiyoto. The Sangha that is arisen from the Dhamma comprises such virtue as good moral practice. Yo tapito ariyabukala sankaseto. They form the group of eight types of noble persons. Sila titamapawara sayagaya tito. They are guided in body and mind by excellent morality and other virtues. Wantamahang tamariyana kanang susutang. To that group of morally pure noble people I pay my respect. Sankoyo sapapaninang saranang kemamotamang. For it is the Sangha that is the highest and secure refuge of all living beings. Tatiya nutsatitanang wantamitang sirenahang. To that Sangha who formed the basis for the third recollection. Sangha sahatsaming taso wa. Or if a girl tasi wa. So as a boy. Sangha sahatsaming taso wa. Sangko me samigitsaro. I am indeed the servant of that Sangha. The Sangha is my great master. Sangko tokatsakata jawitata jahitatsame. The Sangha is my suffering destroyer and my benefit bestower as well. Sankatsahang niyate misariran chiwitanjitang. To the Sangha I sacrifice my body and my life. Wan tan to hang, or if a lady, wan tan ti hang, so as a boy. Wan tan to hang jaritsa mi sangkat so pati panatang. I who rever the Sangha, excellent, well-practiced, the Sangha's excellent, well-practiced way. Nati me saranang anyang, sangko me saranang warang. I have no other refuge. The Sangha is my superb refuge. Etena sajawachena watayang satusasane. By the declaration of this truth, may I be prosperous in the teachings of the great master. Sankang me wantamanena, or if a lady, wantamanaya, so as a boy. Sankang me wantamanena yang bunyang basutang ita. I who rever the Sangha and with the merits I have obtained. Sapepi antaraya me mahesung tatsate jasa. May all dangers be overcome through their power. Then bow to the floor for apologies to the Sangha as the third factor, as the third faculty of focus, of refuge. Gayena wajaya, gayena wajaya wajetasawa, whether by body, speech or mind. Sankhe kukamang bakatang mayayang, whichever evil karma I have committed or may have committed towards the Sangha, knowingly or unknowingly. Sankho badikan hato ajayantang, may the Sangha forgive me for the whole fault. Kalantare sangwaritong wasankhe, for the sake of later restraint and mindfulness towards the Sangha. Apinha bajawekana. Hantamayang. Apinha bajawe kanaba tang panamase. Now let us chant the ideas to be constantly reviewed. This isn't in all evening prayers. Charatamomhi. I am subject to decay. Charang ahatito. I cannot escape decay. Payatitamomhi. I am subject to disease. Payating anatito, I cannot escape disease. Maranatammomhi, I am subject to death. Maranang anatito. These ones that anatito end with anatito. If you're a girl, you end with anatita. Maranang anatito as a boy. Maranang anatita as a girl. So, maranang anatito. I cannot escape death. Sapehi me piehi manapehi. There will be division and separation from all that are dear to me and beloved. Nana pawo wina pawo. Gammatsagomi. I am the owner of my karma. Gammatayato, or if you're a girl, gammatayata, so as a boy, gammatayato, I am the heir of my own karma. Gammayoni, I am born of my karma. Gammapantu, I am related and receive the fruits, or the good or bad fruits of my karma, of my actions. Gammapatisarano, I am related to my karma. Or kamma pati sarana, if you're a woman. I abide and am dependent on my karma. Yang gamman garitsami, whatever karma I have committed, kanlayanang wa papakang wa, be it either good or evil. Tatsatayato pawitsami, I am bound to reap the fruit of that karma. Apinhang bajawe kitapang. Thus these facts should be again and again contemplated. And so that is the main set of verses used in evening prayer, but would continue then with
Ayangayo. Everyone would recite this, that this body, ajirangwata, is not long-lasting. Apeta winyano, when it is devoid of consciousness. Chutto, when consciousness discards it. Atisesate, this body will lie down and fall to the earth. Batawing. Niratangwa galinkarang, and just be like a useless wooden log or a tree trunk. Sankara, all conditioned things. Anicca vata, are impermanent. Ubata vayatammino, they have the nature of being arisen and declined. So entropy, they come into existence and begin to decay. Ubacita va niruchanti, they have the nature of being arising and ceasing. Te sang vupasu mosuko. I say again, te sang vupasamo sukho. Nibbana is the extinction of all defilement and suffering, and it is the great bliss. Sape sata, all living beings. Marante ja maringso ja maritsare, who are dying, have died and are going to die. Date wahang maritsami, it is the same as me who will die too. Nati me eta sangsayo. As for death, I have no doubt about it at all. My own death. Then the following Thai people like to take water and pour it, which some forest monks don't allow because they say it's a Brahmin ritual. The Buddha allowed it, King Bimbisara, to pour water on his hands, and the ritual came from that, and it has been preserved from Brahmin times through the Buddhist era in Thailand, and is still practiced as this following part is chanted, which is called Gruap Nam Donyin, pour water, and they will pour the water on trees afterwards and offer it to their dead relatives. So Hantamayang Otitsana Titana Katayo panamasehi. Now let us recite the verses on the transference of merit and the verses of self-determination. Imina punya kamena. I transfer this merit that is arisen from my practice to Upachaya konutara, my preceptor of great virtue. Ajariyo pakaraja, my teachers who encourage me. Mata pita jayataka, my father, my mother and relatives. Suryo jantima racha, the sun, the moon and the kings, the virtuous people and high-ranking people. Kunawanta narapija, Pramama raja intaja, the Brahma god, the evil one and the Indra god. Lokabala jatewata, the world guardian god and the devas. Yatmo mita ja manodsa, sorry again. Yatmo mita manodsa ja, the lord of death, the friends and human beings. Machata werikapija, the indifferent and the hostile. Sape sata suki honto, may all of these beings be happy and free from unsatisfactoriness. Bunyani bhagatani me, may the wholesome deeds that I may have performed till now. Sukhang ja divitang tento kipang papeta wo matang, may bring you threefold bliss and help you immediately to attain nibbana, referring to offering merit to all of those beings that they may attain nibbana and free from suffering. Imina bunyagamena, by this act of performing wholesome deeds. Imina utitsena ja, and through this act of sharing. Kipahang susape jewa, may I likewise attain the eradicating of tan hupata na chetanang ye santane hina tamma, craving and clinging,
wherever unwholesome deeds I have in mind, yāva nippānato mamang nasanto sapatāyeva, till I attain nibbana, may they be immediately come to an end. Yatha chato pawe pawe ochojitang satipanya. May wherever I am born, may I have an upright mind, mindfulness, and excellent wisdom. Saleko viriyam hina. May these three virtues work together. Mara lapanto nogasang. May there be no chance for all harmful or any harmful influences. Katunja virie sume, to weaken my efforts. Putta tipawaro nato, the Buddha is the supreme refuge. Tammo nato varutamo, the Dhamma is the supreme refuge. Sangho nato taro mamang, the silent Buddha and the Sangha are my true refuges. Teso tamanupavena, by the power of these supreme ones, maroga sangla pantuma, may the evil ones lose their chance. Tasabunya nupavena, through the power of the 10 wholesome deeds, the 10 perfections. Maroga sangla pantuma, may all evil ones cease to manifest their power over me. Putanutsati. Iti piso pakawa arahang samma samputo. Because of reasons such as these, that the Blessed One is, having attained Nibbana, the supremely self-enlightened one, vicca jarana sampanno, the perfect embodiment of wisdom and virtue, sukato lokavitu anuttaro bodhisattamasarati, the auspicious pathfinder, the knower of all realms, the incomparable tamer of individuals and supreme teacher of all devas and men, humans. Sata teva manotsanang puto pakawati, the awakened one who is knowledgeable, self-awakened and blossomed by virtue of the Dhamma, and who possesses the ability to teach the Dhamma selectively. Then would come after this. So wa kato pakovata tammo santitiko akaliko ehibatsiko opanaiko pajatang vetitappo vinyuhiti. The Dhamma is well expounded by the Exalted One, is something which one who learns and truly practices will realize by one's own self. It is also something which can be actually practiced and yields results without the limitations of time. It is also something worthy of telling others to take heed of, and is something which ought to be respectfully observed and adopted, as it is something that can only be realized through personal experience. Supatipannoa pakavato asāvaka saṅkhoa, of good conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One. Ucupatipannoa pakavato asāvaka saṅkhoa, of upright conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One. Yāya patipannoa pakavato asāvaka saṅkhoa, of right conduct is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One, who practice in order to know well the Dhamma, which frees one from suffering. Samiji patipanoa pakovato asavaka sangko yatitang jatari burisayukani. This is the community of noble disciples of the Exalted One. The noble disciples of the Exalted One are such people, namely the four pairs of men, Attaburisa Bukala, Esapakawato Asawaka Sanko, the eight individuals, and this community of noble disciples of the Exalted One is worthy of gifts. Ahunayo, worthy of hospitality, Pahunayo, worthy of reverential salutation, Takinayo Anchali Garaniyo, and worthy of the incomparable field of merit for the world, Anutarang Bunyaketang Lokatsati. This is sometimes followed at the end with the Puttachaya Mankala Katha, which is the victory over the armies of Mara, the stanzas of victory, which I will not do. And so there are various methods and ways of doing Swadvatyen, Thai Buddhist evening prayer. But those are the most important stanzas. It's not the complete formula, and it will be different from temple to temple, so there's no point in actually really learning a particular formula except for learning each verse which is within the evening prayer and understanding it. And whichever temple or ashram or wherever you practice, or if at home, you can make your own formula and keep the essential parts, and you can add further prayers to it, and this is what happens. And so sometimes you can be half an hour to 40 minutes, or you can be 2 hours and 3 hours. Some temples, they never stop. But the point of this particular tutorial or podcast is to familiarize oneself with what one is actually saying, doing, and then if one understands, you can actually mean it when you're saying it. And only there is where spiritual transformation and rapture and connection with the spiritual can occur. So hopefully this will intensify your understanding and your practice of Thai Buddhist evening prayer and chanting. And I hope it benefits everybody in their practice and deepens one's understanding of what it actually is that we should be doing when we're practicing. So this is Ajahn Spencer, hopefully helping others. Signing off. Wishing you all a good night.